Yes, anyone?
Sorry, sir. Actually, I was struggling with the recording. Can you please
Okay.
repeat what is to be
The
found?
question was that from verse 21, there is a repetitive word or a phrase which is also an action of the sense that is getting repeated. Can you please find that within the verses?
Yeah.
It's a small exercise given to everyone so that you
Yes.
can read the verses and see. You can unmute yourself and say it when you're ready.
Is it Gunan?
What does that mean, Piyush?
Virtues or something like that, or
Sorry, say that again.
Gunan.
Okay, what does that mean? What is the mean translation?
The translation of the word Gunan, I mean, I think it is
Sorry, I can't hear you.
virtues, virtues. Gun, like
Huh?
virtues.
Oh, Gunan, virtues. No, 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 no,
No.
it's not that.
Okay.
It's not getting repeated.
Hello,
Yes.
Prabhu.
Yes, Venkat. Okay, Devorshi. Yes, sorry. Sure, sure. Sorry. So,
Samagata.
oh, Soumya. So,
Samagata.
is it Soumadatta?
Yeah,
Or is it
Samagata.
Soumya?
Samagata. Assembled. You said
Which verse is
action.
that? Which is the verse?
1 point. So it's been this word was repeated everywhere actually. Samagata.
Which verse is it? Is it?
One. Sorry, one second.
Yeah.
1.23.
1.23.
Yeah.
Yotsam manan vekshaham ye ete atra samagataha.
Samagata. Samagata. Yeah. Assembled.
Samagataha.
Yeah.
Samagataha. Okay,
Samagata.
where do you see this word again in which verse?
In
Samagataha.
1.27 and 1.26 also, I think. Yeah, I saw this one continuously in few places.
1.27.
Yeah.
1.27. No.
No. I saw a
No.
few places.
Can you tell me which other verse it is in? Okay, Randhir, yes. You might need to unmute. Yeah, sorry, Randhir.
So the word, I mean the article, you know, ka
No,
or sa.
it's not the word. It is an action of the sense. It may be different words, but the phrase would be similar. There's an action which is repeatedly happening. Okay. I'll just do that. The 21 and 22, if you see, Arjuna is saying, take me in the middle of the armies so that I may see. Okay, that's the first occurrence of he wants to see. Seeing. Next, 23. Avekshe, let me see. Can you see that?
Prabhuji, what are the different variations of this word, Aviksha?
So, first one, 21 and 22. Two, it is, he says, first is Nirikshe, let me look upon. So that is one variation, first variation. Let me look upon Nirikshe. Ikshe. So that is seeing. So let me see. Let me look upon them. Then 23rd, he says Avekshe. Let me see. Can you find out? Are you able to figure that out? Yes. Then 24th, is it there in 24th? Bhishma Drona Pramukhatah Sarvesham cha Mahikshitam. Ikshi, that is also seeing, but it's not translated here, unfortunately. That's okay. We can leave that as a doubtful occurrence because it's not explained properly. 26th, third time, I could see. He could see Apashyat. Again, repeat it. Seeing. Yeah? Okay. So what is happening repeatedly? Arjuna is seeing. Yeah? Constantly. Seeing everything. Now we'll read verse 27 because we discussed 26 last time, right? So we'll continue reading from verse 27. Please repeat after me.
So we did 27.
Did we? I think we did,
yes,
26.
Sir, he was filled with compassion.
Okay. Okay. So in 27 also he saw. After seeing. Samiksha. Can you see that? So you see the repetition of seeing.
Yes, but so many words.
Yeah, does it make sense? Sorry?
So many words for seeing.
Yeah, so this is repetition. But we often miss it because the thing is, you know, I'll tell you, after reading Bhagavad Gita, I learned how to read. Sorry. I learned how to read slowly. It is very hard. Trust me. Reading... You know, reading is like you have to read it 4 to 5 times, the same thing, in order to really read it. And you will be able to observe the things if you are interested in that topic or if you really like it. So you'll be able to observe things like this. You'll find out whether this is actually the thing I want to read or no. You'll find out new things out of it.
Prabhuji, could you guide me, please? I'm on 27.
Okay.
Just please guide me if I'm on the correct page.
Sure. Can someone share the link of verse 27?
Well, what I have here is Brahmano hi pratishtaham. Is that correct?
Oh, verse 27 starts with Tan samikshyatsa kaunteya.
Okay.
Did you find it, Piyush?
This is.
Brother, I've dropped it on WhatsApp and on this chat as well.
So, Devarishi has sent it on WhatsApp, the link for 1.27. Did you find it, Piyush?
Yes, I found it.
So, Samikshya is after seeing. Yes, Randir.
Sir, I think this concept of he became overwhelmed with compassion, I think we have done this last week, sir.
No problem. Yeah. No problem. So what I'm trying to get at is the repeatedness of one particular action which Arjuna is doing from past 6-7 verses. So what happens? What happens when you see? What happens when you see? What happens inside you when you start seeing too many? Seeing things, especially when you are at some task. You develop perception. Yes? You perceive, you start perceiving. And this is very important. What happens is perception shapes the emotions. This is very important. Perception, once you start perceiving, perception will shape your emotions. And that is what is going to happen in the next verse.
Okay.
So highlight this very important thing. Up till here, now this is a turning point in Bhagavad Gita. It's turning from Sanya Nirikshan Yoga to Arjuna Vishad Yoga. Lamentation. See what happens when the emotions develop. And which are the basis of, which are from, source from the perception, and which is developed from the sense. One of the horses we had discussed in the chariot. Yes? Last time. What are the horses? They are the senses. The sense has developed a perception. The perception has built the emotions. See, this is the philosophy behind it. So understand the logic. So we'll read the next verse. Verse 28. Everyone okay with verse 27? No problem? Yeah? Okay. Please repeat after me. Now you can unmute yourself. Arjuna Uvacha. Drishtve mam swajanam Krishna. Yuyutsava yuyutsam samupasthitam. Siddhanti mama gatrani.
Siddhanti mama gatrani.
Mukham cha parishrati.
Mukham cha parishrati.
Arjuna uvacha.
Arjuna uvacha.
Drishtvem swajanam Krishna. Yuyutsum samupasthitam.
Yuyutsum samupasthitam.
Siddhanti mama gatrani.
Siddhanti mama gatrani.
Mukham cha parishruyati.
Mukham cha parishruyati.
Arjuna uvacha.
Arjuna
vacha.
Drishtve mam swajanam Krishna. Yuyutsum samupasthitam.
Yuyutsum samupasthitam.
Yuyutsum samupasthitam.
Siddhanti mama gatrani.
Siddhanti mama gatrani.
Mukham cha parishushyati.
Mukham cha parishushyati.
Mukham cha parishushyati.
Yeah, it's parishushyati.
Parishru.
Parishushyati.
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 Right?
Yeah. First, the pronunciation we start learning is Parishushyati. Only then we will be able to say Parishushyati.
Okay.
Parishushyati.
So it will get too complicated if you say Parishushyati first.
Yes.
So Parishushyati, learn Parishushyati. Then there is a ra between sha and shu. Parishushyati.
Parishushyati.
Parishrushyati. Yeah. You know, if someone learns Sanskrit from the beginning, from his birth, he will never lisp, or he will never be a lisper. That's why we did not have lisper in India before. It's all coming from the West.
Now every type of lisper is there.
So there are very different types. English. Yes. All right. Okay. Now I will also unmute my, I will also mute myself. Can someone read the translation? Maybe Piyush. Yeah.
Arjuna said, "My dear Krishna, seeing my friends and relatives present in such a fighting spirit, I feel the limbs of my body quivering and my mouth drying up.
see the reaction of the perception. So it affects your body directly. So when we say that we need to be healthy, we have to see things which are healthy. We have to eat things which are healthy. We have to hear things which are healthy. So it is garbage in, garbage out, as we say. So as soon as you see something which is unpleasant, you create a perception, and that perception can affect your body. That's what is happening with Arjuna. So generally, all the senses, you know, when they are having some unpleasant experience, they will affect you. But vision affects the most. Vision affects the most. So the effect of vision is most, although the most sensitive is the ear. Is it making sense? Ear is more sensitive. The hearing propensity is more sensitive than the seeing sensitive, seeing propensity. But seeing is the more effective sense. You get affected more by seeing. This is the understanding, you know, a deeper understanding of this verse. And that happens with Arjun, that when he sees, so see what happens. Before, he was saying the evil sons of Dhritarashtra, Dhritarashtra, you know, he was saying the evil sons of Dhritarashtra just two verses before. Now he's saying, what happens is that he was with that mindset going to fight with the sons of Dhritarashtra, but now he sees Bhishma, you know, his grandfather, whom has, you know, whom was playing with, yeah, and when he was a child, and he sees others, his brothers, you know, his well-wishers, also he has to fight them as well. When he sees that, he generates a perception. And that perception is affecting him with his senses. What is the effect? His mouth drying up, his body quivering. So he's shaking. Yeah? And why is it happening with him? What it is... of the so compassion has joined with the reaction of the senses is effect.
Prabhuji, I have a question here.
Yes, who's the is it Devarishi?
Piyush.
No, Piyush, yes, Piyush.
So intuition, where, what is that? Is it a feeling that comes from the seeing sense or the smelling sense, the hearing sense? What?
Sorry, can you say that again? I lost you in the middle. I couldn't hear you.
Certainly. So I was saying that intuition, how do we, since we were talking about the seeing and the hearing sense, want to know that when I say that my intuition tells me a certain thing, is that coming from the seeing sense or the hearing sense? Where is that placed in the Bhagavad Gita's explanation of intuition?
Okay, very good question, Piyush.
Yeah.
Does anyone remember? We discussed this last time. Or would someone like to answer this precisely? Someone would like to answer that? Yes, okay, Randhir, give it a shot.
Sir, you'd mentioned the five senses and you'd mentioned that the sixth one would be intuition. I mean, there is
a little,
the five
a ones little more detail, known. A little more detail on that.
So the five ones which automatically give the inputs to a normal human being. Right? And
so what
the
are they?
Sixth one, I mean, so eyesight, hearing, sense of feeling, sense of touch. So the remaining two, I wouldn't know because I don't remember them.
Okay. From taste school. And smell.
Taste and smell. Okay.
So there are five gross senses. Five gross senses.
Right.
Please remember that. So right. This is smell, see, taste, touch, and tongue. Eat.
Right. And okay. They are the horses, right?
Okay. So we are not giving chariot example. What we are answering, Piyush, is what is that intuition? What is that intuition, that gut feeling? Am I right, Piyush?
Yes.
If I'm wrong. Isn't that the gut feeling you're talking about? The intuition?
Yes, yes, Prabhuji. Like when something, when somebody means ill towards you, right? When somebody yes. is doing something out of malice, immediately yes. look at it and something inside you says, yaar, ye galat hai. Like there's something wrong with this. So that maybe that's correct. Fine in layman's terms.
Yes. Yeah. A gut feeling or an intuition. Guilt, when you're doing something wrong, these are all inbuilt senses. I'll give you a very simple example. It is like we have two dogs in our body. One is a good dog and one is a bad dog. This is explained by my, you know, my guru to me. One is a bad dog and one is a good dog. Okay. Generally, the bad dog barks a lot and the good dog is very meek. You know? So when you do something wrong, the good dog comes into picture. He stops you. And the bad dog also comes into picture. He asks you to do it, saying that no problem. Now it depends on now which dog will bark or which dog will succeed to convince you depends on which dog you feed the most. Does it make sense, Piyush? So always when you do something wrong, you will have your good dog barking. You'll also have the bad dog barking. But whom do you want to feed is your choice. If you continue feeding your bad dog over a period of time, the bad dog becomes so strong that he doesn't allow the good dog to bark. That's how criminals are made. Does it make sense? So, is this sinking in?
So Guruji, I would say intuition then is the good dog barking.
Correct.
Yeah.
It can also be the bad dog barking. You may get an intuition for killing someone if you have fed it.
Right. Makes sense.
Does it make sense? Yeah. It can be good or bad. You don't know.
So intuition is basically then like a sixth sense. It's not.
You can say that, yes.
It's not your daily five senses that you use.
No, it is not among the gross senses, no.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. It is also termed as the mind, sixth sense. Okay. Did it answer your question?
Yes, probably. That was, it answered the question.
Cool. Okay. So this is what happened with Arjun after seeing the perception developed, the compassion, which was dormant, underdeveloped, rose, and he became too much compassionate and his body started reacting. So this is what happened in verse 28. Now, from 28 verse onwards, it's a monologue of Arjun because he starts speaking and he will continue to speak. Till this time, he was just saying something and, you know, and then Krishna was doing that and all that. Now he'll continuously speak for some time. So we'll read verse 29. Everyone with me? If you can go to verse 29. Yes.
Very good.
All good. Any reading was a quick one.
Yeah, Guruji, may I try to translate? I mean, may I try to speak this in Sanskrit?
Which one? Which one? 29. Who wants to try? Who wants to try? I don't see anyone. Sorry. Piyush. Yes, you can. You can. Just before that, in verse 28, is there something which you have observed in verse 28? It's a quick question. If you notice in verse 28, it is the first time so far Krishna has been used. That's why it is a highlighted verse, 1.28. First time in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna word comes. Can you see that? The actual name of Krishna. It is not Krishna, it is Krishna. That's where it says that this is the real name of Krishna. Arjuna is calling him by that name. That is the real name of Krishna. This is how we should pronounce Krishna. Yes? Can you read it? Yes, in Sanskrit, that is Krishna. If any of you knows how to read Devanagari script, you'll be able to see that word there, Krishna. Yeah? Okay. So this is the first verse where in Bhagavad Gita, where Krishna name is, you know, is said here by Arjun. Okay, verse 29. All yours, Piyush.
Vepathushcha
sharirame.
Umaharascha jayate.
Roma harshascha jayate.
Gandivas shramshate hastata.
Gandivam shramshate hastas.
Tvakchaiva paridahyate.
Tvakchaiva paridahyate. We'll say that again. Vepathuscha sharire me.
Vepathuscha sharire me.
Roma harshascha jayate.
Roma
harshascha jayate.
Kandivam shramashate hastat.
Kandivam shramashate hastat.
Tvakcheva paridhayate. Do you want to say that again, Piyush? One more time?
Yes. Vepathuschata sharirame.
Vepathuschata sharirame.
Roma harashchacha jayate.
Roma harshascha jayate.
Gandivam shramshate hastata.
Gandivam shramasate hastata.
Tvakchaiva paridahyate.
Tvakchaiva paridahyate. Okay. Anyone would like to read the translation? Maybe Abhijit would like to read the translation? Abhijit, are you there?
Yeah. And
okay. Okay, no problem.
I would request you to.
Okay, Debarishi, would you like to try the translation?
Yes, Prabhupada. My whole body is trembling. My hair is standing on end. My bow, Gandiva, is slipping from my hand and my skin is burning.
So further reactions after looking at. So what state, you know, Arjun is getting into, you see. It's getting worse. It's not getting better after seeing everyone. So what are the physical effects of emotions after the new perception? You see, throat dried up, limbs quivering, you know. Now what's happened, and after that his skin is burning, his Gandiva is slipping from his hand. Gandiva is the bow of Arjun. That's the name of Arjuna's bow, Gandiva. Okay. What did Arjun want before? He wanted to see, and that is called Pratyaksha Pramana. Sometimes we also demand a Pratyaksha Pramana. Like when we read Bhagavad Gita, you know, when we read it, we say Bhagwan Uvacha. We say Krishna is speaking, and Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead or Supreme Divine or God. As we say, Krishna is God. The next question everyone asks is, have you seen Krishna? Have you seen God? So everyone in this world generally wants a Pratyaksha Pramana. They want to see. Yeah? And Arjun also wanted to see this. But Pratyaksha Pramana sometimes has a repercussion. It's not sometimes the final way. Yeah? In this context, I'm not speaking, but generally, Pratyaksha Pramana may not be the final way. When there is over-reliance on seeing, you know, so that's getting repeated all the time in, you know, from the last few verses, that seeing, 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 and now the repercussions. See, Arjuna wanted to see, but when there is an over-reliance of Pratyaksha, that we totally depend upon seeing and believing, what happens then? We generally get into illusion. And that is called Maya. We talk about all these things, right? Maya, 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 Maya hai, Maya hai, sab Maya hai. It is not that. Maya is depending too much on seeing. Is illusion. Does it make sense? So generally, this is what the tendency is. This is where even the science has the same thing. Seeing is believing. But then when it comes to Shastra, hearing is believing. Paroksha Pramana. If it is written in the Shastras, it is true. But whereas in this material world, what you see is true. This should open up a lot of questions, I'm sure. Anyone want to comment on this one?
No, I would just like to say, I guess that's why it's called the great illusion, right? Because that's what we are seeing, the Maya, currently.
Yeah, good, good. If that's your understanding, yeah, it's your own thought, yes. Yeah, this is something you should write down because that's your own. Yes, anyone else? See, such a beautiful thing you got in your you know, in your thoughts just now. Can you say that again, Piyush?
Yes. I was something that just like Prabhuji said, it occurred to me that Maya is like Prabhuji said, seeing is believing. What we see today is just Maya. It's an illusion.
You said something high. So high illusion. What did you say on high illusion?
No, I just said it is the Maya. I mean, as many people have called it, Maya is the great illusion.
Correct. Anyone else? Devarishi, did you want to add anything?
So today is election results day in Bengal, and I really need Krishna today.
Sure, you can chant his name. He's with you then. Very simple. Kali Kale Krishna Nam Rupa Avatar. If you take my name, I'm with you. That's what he says.
Yes, probably I'll
yeah. You think about me, you take my name, I'm with you. That's what he says. Yeah. Anyone would like to add or comment on Maya illusion?
Prabhuji, Rishi this side.
Yes, Rishi.
Not on Maya, but on this verses 28 and 29. Just my understanding of the reaction that Arjun is giving. Like normally when, especially in 28, it says, you know, when he saw everybody in their fighting spirit. So like if normal life, if we see somebody go and try to talk to them and they have a big ego or they are, you know, in a fighting spirit, you become in that fighting spirit also. You say, "Acha, you will fight with me, I'll also fight with you." But Arjun is giving a very, Arjun had a different thinking. He was actually going in saying, "I'm going to fight with these, you know, supporters of Duryodhan and or sons of Dhritarashtra." And now after actually seeing them, the reaction is completely opposite. It is not, "Oh, they want to kill me, I'll kill them first." It's different. So I found that slightly sort of a comment on Arjun's attitude or his nature.
Which shows his compassion, isn't it?
Yes.
He's compassionate.
He's genuinely compassionate. He doesn't care what to...
Yeah, very, very nice observation, Rishi. Very nice, yeah. See, this is your own understanding. Yeah, you should put it down for yourself. So after a year or two, when we reach chapter 8 or 9, you go back on chapter 1 and read this now, you'll realize, oh my God, I had written this. It's very nice, you know, when you make notes of these things. Very good observation. Anyone else?
Yeah, Prabhuji, Kshitij here.
Yes, Kshitij.
One observation I have is, we're talking about Maya. There are two kinds of things usually happen in terms of, like, in case of Arjun, he has become soft-heartedness is one of the features, is what is written in the verse. So he's become kind of compassionate towards people against whom he's going to fight, instead of having that mindset that he will fight and kill them. So I see that quality of becoming soft-heartedness and finding no reason that he should not fight against those people who are his relatives, of course. So I see it as, you know, when you are seeing that you are going to have some benefit of doing an action or activity, which is by killing them, he is going to get the kingdom. But on the other side, his heart has become soft-hearted, where he's feeling that, no, this is not the right thing to do. I'll have some benefit in this material world, but I'll lose a lot of things in my life.
Some more addition to his compassion.
Yeah.
Healing. Yeah. Yeah. Very good. Anyone want to say something more on this? Or we can continue? Aditi, do you want to add in something? Or any comments?
No, we can go ahead.
No. Okay. Yes. Venkat?
Not sure, Guruji. Maya, we heard about Maya, but I don't know. Everyone spoke about it.
It's okay. Okay. All right. Okay. What we see... Just listen to this. This is very important. Now, what we see with our eyes, we have to connect it with the scriptures. We have to try and connect it with the scriptures, with the Shastras. That is the Bhagavad Gita, to start with. So when we see something and we connect it with what we are reading, then learn from that new perception. Okay. So when you learn Bhagavad Gita, when you will learn that I am not this body, I am the soul, which will come in chapter 2, then you will be able to relate it. Then seeing will be a different perception. I mean, seeing will give you a different perception. Seeing will not give you the same perception. And that is called Shastra Chakshu. Seeing through the eyes of scriptures. So perception has to be subordinated with shabda. So one is pratyaksha pramana and the other thing is shabda pramana. So pratyaksha has to be subordinated with the shabda. Shastra shabda takes out that illusion. So when you see, you may come into the maya. When you see, seeing is believing, seeing is believing, seeing is believing, maya. Add in the shabda, shastra to it, maya goes away. Now you connect. Now your perception is correct. That clears your perception. That is where the shastra comes into picture. That's where the shabda comes into picture. That's where Bhagavad Gita comes into picture. Is it making sense? Yes, or is it too deep? Everyone with me on this?
Yeah, it is too deep. We'll take time to understand.
Okay. Okay. What did you understand from the last verse, Aditi, about seeing? What happened to Arjun after seeing? Yes, Aditi.
Yeah, after seeing everything, he became anxious.
He started having reactions on his body. His hands started getting sweaty. Yeah. His throat was dried up. His bow was slipping away from his hands. His hair all got up. That's called goosebumps, right? He was getting all that kind of reaction from his body after seeing. Yeah. So what is that? He is in illusion. That's what happens to us. Because we have certain perception after seeing. Say, for example, now in India, you have your loved one who's on the deathbed and he is gone. Yeah, he lost his body, say, for example. You have a kind of a reaction on you, right? You cry. You feel bad. Yes?
Yes.
You feel stressed.
Yes.
You feel hurt. But does that make you eligible to help other person?
No.
It doesn't. Actually, it drains the energy out from you, which is should be required to help the other person. Correct?
Yes.
So what is intelligence? To save that energy or to drain that energy?
Save that energy.
So the feeling inside to control that, to have a positive feeling amidst this calamity is called shabda. That's where you need shastra. Does it make sense?
Yeah, somewhat.
When you see something, but when you have a shabda pramana, so when you see something is called pratyaksha pramana, and shastra is the shabda pramana, so you have pratyaksha pramana and you have the shabda pramana, that takes out the illusion and you have a better feeling inside.
Okay.
To deal with the situation. Is this making sense?
Yes, somewhat. Yeah, I will.
Okay. Yeah. Yes, Piyush.
So basically, Prabhuji, what you know we can say is that what Gita is trying to tell us is that when we actually try to come out of the Maya, the illusion, what happened? There is started sweating, body started, you know, changes started happening. That is the level of how can we say? That is how much we are used to the illusion that when we start coming out of it, these reactions happen.
That's so, when we have these kind of reactions, which can be misleading, which definitely can be misleading, this perception, these sensory perceptions, because these are sensory perceptions. The senses are reacting due to some perception. Yeah?
Right. So, apparently...
So, when we have sensory perceptions, which can be misleading, that is when... we have to consult Shastra, Guru, or Sadhus. These are the three things to consider: Guru, Sadhu, Shastra. So we are consulting Shastra. We are consulting Bhagavad Gita. Okay. So three places we have to get the Shabda Pramana from: Guru, Sadhu, and Shastra. Bhagavad Gita will tell you who is the right guru, and it will also tell you what the types of gurus. It will also tell you who is the sadhu. It will tell you everything over a period of time. So at the moment we are consulting Shastra, Bhagavad Gita. Okay. So feeling emotions of compassion, as we discussed, you know, are actually what Rishi and Chittaj said. They are the qualities of a devotee, of a pure devotee of Krishna. Krishna. Yeah. So devotee is calling Krishna Krishna. So that is his the real name. So the compassion, actually a noble and signs of a pure devotee. It's a very noble quality. So further physical effects which he had in 29, trembling of the body, hair on the body standing up, Gandiva, bow slipping, skin burning. Have you felt this? I have. Have you felt these kind of things? Hands sweaty, yes. Skin, yes. Burning.
Yeah? Yes.
Throat drying up. Such a, yes, situation, a calamitic situation, you know. All these things happen. So Arjun is actually our representative to Krishna, asking questions which we would ask. So that is the way we should be reading Bhagavad Gita, putting ourselves in Arjun's shoes. generally these emotions, because you know, emotions have very quick reactions on females, very quick reactions, of course on males also, but they are quicker in females, but they do come on males also. And Arjun is actually receiving them. So you imagine a Kshatriya getting them, what kind of effect he might be receiving out of his sensory perceptions. But that's why it is for a warrior, you know, like Arjun getting such effects. Kshatriya having such effects is very dangerous. It's very dangerous because he has to fight. His job is to fight. Compassion, if you read in the purport, so I would request everyone to read the purport of, you know what is a purport, right? The purport is just after the translation, below the big paragraphs. So I'm expecting all of you to read the purports of 28, 29, and we will read 30 also quickly, so you can read the purport of 30. Do we have Nabraj with us?
Hari Bol, everyone. Prabhu, yes, I am.
Hari Bol, Prabhu. Would you like to read verse 30?
If you wish, Prabhu.
Yes, sure, I wish.
Thank you. Nacha sankrome basthatum.
Nacha sankrome basthatum.
Brahma bita cha me mana.
Brahma diva cha me mana.
Nacha sankrome basthatum.
Nacha sankrome basthatum.
Brahma diva cha me mana.
Brahma diva cha me mana.
Nimittani cha pashyami.
Nimittani cha pashyami.
Viparitani kesava.
Viparitani kesava.
One more time.
Sure.
Nacha sakrome basthatum.
Nacha sakrome basthatum.
Brahmati vacha me mana.
Brahmati vacha me mana.
निमित्तानि च पश्यामि
निमित्तानि च पश्यामि
विपरीतानि केशव
विपरीतानि केशव. ओके ऋषि, वुड यू लाइक टू रीड द ट्रांसलेशन प्लीज.
यस. आई एम नाउ अनएबल टू स्टैंड हियर एनी लॉन्गर. I am forgetting myself and my mind is reeling. I see only causes of misfortune, O Krishna, killer of the KC demon.
Okay. So, what is the name of Krishna in this verse? Anyone?
Keshava.
Keshava. Who is that, Chitij? Yes?
Yeah.
Keshava. Why is he called Keshava?
No idea on that.
He's a killer of the KC demon.
Correct. It is said in the translation. Because he is the killer of KC demon, he is called Keshava. So all of his names, if you see, Krishna's names, are based on events. Yeah. Most of his names are based on events. Most of the names are based on his pastime. Most of his names are based on his, you know, activities which he has done. So that's how his different names are. So Keshav is one of those names because he killed the KC demon.
Like Murari is because he plays the Murli.
So you can find out all these names. There are many names of Krishna which have a meaning of his pastime. Okay. Now I would request everyone to read the purport from 27, 28, 29 and 30. All these purports. And we will continue from verse 31. And try to find a question of Arjun to Krishna. Try to find if there is any question which is asking. This will be an exercise for you. So if you go through these verses and try to find, if you see, if he's asking something, if he's saying something, or if he's requesting something, you know, or any other of his feelings, is trying to say something to Krishna. Okay? So we'll discuss that in our next class. You can make a note of it if you like, and, you know, you can discuss that. If you want, you can actually, we can make two groups, you know, and both of you can have a kind of, you know, note on that one as to what are the feelings, what are the question he's, if there is any question hidden in this, in these verses, if he's getting there somewhere. Do you want to do that? Do you want to make two groups and talk to each other? Do you want to do that? Or do you want to... Okay. Yeah? Do you want to make it two groups or do you want to do it individually?
Group is good, Prabhuji.
Group is good?
Yes.
Yeah? What do you think, Abhijit?
Individually?
You want to do individual, Aditi, or you want to have a group? You'll get more ideas if you do it.
I'm okay with anything.
You're okay with anything. Okay. So she's okay with anything. Abhijit? Rishi?
Anything, Prabhuji.
Okay. Chitij?
Anything is fine.
Okay, the reason why I'm saying groups, so during the week you'll have interaction with each other, you know, on Bhagavad Gita. Anytime you can discuss with you all, you know, among each other. And then there will be some time in the week also with Bhagavad Gita. What do you say?
That's a good idea, Prabhuji.
Yeah? Okay. So
I suppose you can give us the groups then.
No, you can have one and two. Very simple. So starting with Abhijit, I'll go in this order. If you say, start saying one, and then the next person says two. Okay. If you see on the Jitsi link, I have Abhijit first, then I have Piyush, then I have Venkat, then I have Aditi. So I'll start with Abhijit first. So you start say one, and then Piyush can two, and then one, two. Does that make sense?
Okay.
Okay, Abhijit.
One.
Two.
Three.
No, no. Only two groups.
It's 1, 2, 1, 2.
Oh, okay. One.
Who was that?
Venkat.
Venkat. Okay. Aditi.
Okay, two.
Debarishi.
One.
Nabraj.
One.
It is two, right?
Nabraj.
Yeah.
No, sorry, two.
That's okay. Kshitij.
One.
Rishi.
Two.
Randhir.
One.
Abhijit again. I'll say two, but I'll be quiet. Okay. So everyone knows their...
You missed out Kalpesh.
Yeah, so Kalpesh can be in the two. Abhijit, yeah. Can you keep a track of that, please?
Yes, yes.
Great. So one and two groups, you can talk to each other during the week. You have all your numbers in the WhatsApp group. Talk to each other.
But one thing, I don't know where everybody is staying. So there are a lot of time differences.
No, just chat. Just send a chat between each other and confirm a time or something. Right?
Aditi, mostly the problem is with Australian people. But after 10 o'clock, they are free. 10 o'clock in the morning, Indian time.
Okay.
You don't have a Canada guy in your this thing. Canada guy is in my scope, so no problem.
I think Kalpesh is in your group, Aditi, so you can talk to him.
Yeah.
Okay, so Kalpesh is in. Okay, that's better.
So
Sydney is 4.5 hours ahead of Mumbai.
Yeah.
Just for.
Yeah. No problem. Kalpesh and I can coordinate.
So, one and two group, all of you, you know, I don't know who you know your group number. You coordinate with each other.
I'll just reconfirm. Reconfirm group one is Abhijit, Venkat, Randhir, Debarishi, Kshitij.
Yeah.
Yeah, Venkat?
Yeah, yeah.
Right? Debarishi was one, Kshitij was one, and Randhir was one.
That's right.
Rest all are in group two. That is Rishi, Piyush, Aditi, Navraj, and Kalpesh.
And Prabhuji as well.
Oh, that is Kalpesh actually. I said two for Kalpesh. Yeah, yeah.
Ah, okay.
You can take me any group, no problem. I have to keep quiet because I can't say this.
Yes. You are the Karta Dharta.
No. Karta Dharta is Krishna. I'm just asking the question.
No, of this group. Of this group. I'm talking about this group. I'm not going on to the universe at all.
That is Karta Dharta of this group is Kalpesh.
No, he is the Mahamantri.
Guruji Venkat here.
Yes, Venkat, yes.
Guruji, Kalpesh is my friend, so I can I be in the two, so I can chat with him all the time.
Don't worry, Venkat, you can chat with anyone you like, but just be with your group and answer someone, yeah?
Yeah, it doesn't mean that I wanted to chat with everyone.
Yeah,
but, Kalpesh is
very good. You can chat with Kalpesh, no problem. Yeah. But the thing is that among your group, what will happen, you guys will know each other, you know, that's also will be a good exercise.
But that's very good, yeah, that's really good, yeah.
So, because you will know,
Venkat wants
also
to switch the group or something. What was the question about?
No. He was saying that can he chat with Kalpesh? He can always chat with Kalpesh. But what I'm telling him is that if you are in the group other than Kalpesh, it will be a good idea to talk to other people also and discuss Bhagavad Gita. You know, you'll come to know new things. And in future also, we will do this exercise so that we build a nice team, you know, and get to know about each other.
Guruji, in fact, we are already talking about Bhagavad Gita. Whenever we talk about that Gita and about you and, you know, about how this is good happening, you know, stuff like that.
Gita is so sweet, isn't it? Once Bhagavad Gita starts, Bhagavad Gita, nothing else will be spoken, I'm sure.
Yeah, Kalpesh is fully involved in that now. You know, I see a different Kalpesh now, you know. I mean, it's really good to see him like that.
I believe all of you all are involved as well.
Definitely, I was involved, but you know, yes. The things are beautiful now. You know, the conversation what we have going through.
Yeah,
it's absolutely amazing, and amazing about these things, Bhagavad Gita. It's very, you know, it makes us so these things, you know.
That's encouraging. That's very encouraging. Yeah. And this group, you know, slowly once we have all of us, slowly, you know, we will build a family so that, you know, we can share our realizations.
Yeah.
And once we have an intact group after chapter two, there won't be any new additions after chapter two, because that's when the philosophy will actually start. So after that, we will be, once we reach chapter six and chapter eight, chapter seven and chapter eight, there'll be a lot of things which will be that personal, but it's up to you, you can share or not. That will be clarified also in Bhagavad Gita. So we will slowly, slowly, everyone opens up, you know, their darkest secrets also.
Yeah.
It will be very interesting, you know, and we will get those, you know, kind of discussed through Bhagavad Gita. Okay. So we'll end our discussion here. If anyone has any questions or comments, please let me know. Are the questions clear for the next time? Yeah?
Yes, Prabhu.
Okay, fantastic. Okay, have a good weekend, whatever is left, and we will catch up next Sunday.
Thank you, Guruji.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.